2017, we went to Israel in a kibbutz near the Sea of Galilee and visited Tiran and Ella's hydroponic and aquaponic farm. It is the most beautiful, small and smart farm I've ever seen. I can't wait to show you around. Please enjoy and learn while watching.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Yarok Bakfar in Hebrew, green in the village. We are a hydroponic and aquaponic farm. Basically, 3 years ago, we started building this place. We are growing around 20,000 heads a month. We grow biotically with a variety of microorganisms. We grow in the back, we will see it soon, a nice aquaponic farm on emerging. We grow microgreens in the side. We have a vertical farm and we have floating rafts. Basically, we're trying to give a system for every plant so we can create different products in the farm. So it's not one line. We have 30 different varieties. Let's do a small tour. This is from an organic grower up in a mountain behind us. We're gonna grow at least between 7 to 10 trays a week of 10 cc plants. The system is very simple. Big pipes. I don't want all those little pipes to be clogged with bio garbage, let's call it like that. Those two systems, for example, we create about 5 to 6 varieties of greens. Everything is pushed by hand, just with cardboards. We push the whole system forward. We have shrimps in the water. We have some kinds of red worms, blood worm in Hebrew, worms that you can find it for aquariums, for food, for fish, the same type, the exact type. Feeding on our debris of our leftovers after harvest, of course, help create the circle and the live swamp with oxygen spring that we try to create in the systems. And so far, for the last 3 years, it works great. So basically, we start with the 10 cc's plants that we get from the plantery, but they start very small. Like I said, in 10 cc's media with coconut, kavul, and so on. Perlite, vermiculite, all the ratios are known. We put them very dense for about 10 days, it depends of the season. You can see that there is no dead ones. I mean, most plants that I plant in the beginning are becoming mature and go to harvest. This one, for example, something is wrong. So when we're gonna move it to the next level, we're gonna discard him or throw him to the other trays for mixed salads. In this NFT system, we are growing in A-frames. What I did personally here, I'm not recommend that for everybody. I adjust or I found the species that can grow in this and that certain amount of light. I'm talking about the minimum level, of course, because I can grow up to 4.5 times than what I can grow in the floating rafts pool that we just saw. And the products are looking very good in the end. I mean, we're talking about big size Swiss chard or mangold, how we call it in Israel. I weigh without the roots about 200 grams so far. I wish it will get to 250, up to 300, of course. We all know that in hydroponic this is the issue. This one is not like the perfect one from the field, but of course it's very tasty. It's literally sweet. You can feel the sweetness in your mouth. Oh yeah, we wake up at 5 to 5.5. We start early, we finish late, and we love it. Simply that. Before that, I was a military man. This is a little bit better. We're growing biotically, let's call it like that, and not a sterilized hydroponic system. The symbiosis and the products that this system creates and recycle, and the availability of microelements due to understanding their process and due to understanding their protocols, they simply taste much better. For example, the lettuce will get sweet and obviously not bitter. Parsley, green onion, chives, celery, watercress and so on will be very, very strong. Our products can survive alive in good quality up to a month in a fridge, and they don't and just don't have to wash it, they don't need to wash it, they don't want to wash it. There is no sand, there is no bugs, there is no dust, so why would I wash it? If I wash it, I break it and then it's decomposed and all that. Here we grow microgreens in a big variety. We have at the moment osaka, rokat, tatsoi. Up here we have the red Mizona. This is a new part for us, so they are getting better each and every time. And we like to save space, so we always building high. Even if of course we need to take a ladder, it's another few grams for a harvest for the farm. So here is one of our outside or dirt growing. This place, before I cleaned it and took over it, that was a big place to contain cows. What I'm meaning, in the end, the soil here, it's perfect. We have 20, 25 years of soil without that the nutrients stayed inside. We have a beautiful ground. The fertilizer that I use for that is a fertilizer that I make from our biogas container. We use the biogas to heat the water for the fish, and the leftovers, I mean the fertilizers, I divide it and I dilute it in water, and I give it straight up or to the soil with great results. The company was started by my wife and I 5 years ago. We are partners with a company that her name is Living Green. In Living Green we're doing commercial systems as well as household systems. We're doing systems for schools, for people with disabilities, for senior citizens and so on. We have more than 300 little projects across the country, and obviously we are aiming for people to grow more and you know, easily growing their own food. These simple systems for me are a flowing river. We have a flowing river that comes from the upper tank, the aquaponic tank with the fish. Here we have all the bio media. Of course the plants love to grow in it. Here the taste and the aroma of stuff are 5 times better than in the ground, 2 times better than in the bio hydroponic. What we use here is organic sprays and natural enemies, from tree frogs to dragonfly, aphidius, orius, ladybugs. Every winter we try to collect them and throw them inside the greenhouse. Inside we have the compost worms, so when we harvest and we pick the goods out, obviously we get a few percentage back to the system. We have our own line of bell siphons that we create and sell. We use and gather our knowledge and our equipment, and we thought what could be the best way to grow here. We close with concrete all the exits. We grow here in 11 to 13 cubic meters of water. We grow here around 1,000 fish. All our waste, everything is going to feed our sheep that we grow for milk and for meat, to feed our goats for milk, to feed our chicken for eggs and meat, and the leftovers that we can't give them to the animals to eat, we throw in the biogas that we will see later on for further production. The end result, I mean, all the leftovers, all the feces and manure of the animals, we have compost piles in our orchards, we grow olives, we grow mango, and we again circulate everything back to the ground. One more thing that I want to show you, it's the biogas system. If you can look inside, this pit hole just devour all the non-edible for the farm animal, non-edible vegetables and roots if they're a little bit decomposed or rotten or even fermented a little bit, so it's disqualified for the animals. We also have the methane gas. I have 2 hours of medium-sized cooking fire a day. For every liter of volume that we get in, we have the same volume of amazing fertilizer.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm expecting your thumbs up if you liked it. Please subscribe to my channels. There are way more videos to watch. Most of them are in French, but don't be scared. You can activate the English subtitles. Yes, you can. See you around. Ciao.